leg dip. Good old Bub can't be beat. Okay, what about the Roman Empire versus the bubonic plague? Who wins? Which Romans? Just the original Roman Empire, not the Holy Roman Empire or the Byzantine Empire. Just the original ancient Roman Empire. Okay, but picture this. Picture this. The final countdown, okay? The final countdown. This is the finals here. Both of them have done... This is the finals, okay? Both of the contestants have shown very strong showings. They've had very strong showings. Mesopotamia versus a meteorite. The meteorite has prep time. I don't know if the meteorite needs prep time, to be honest. Okay, for the sake of argument, we'll say the meteorite is as big as Mesopotamia. Like, the city of Uruk. Not the size of Mesopotamia itself, but the size of Uruk. The original civilization. How big was that? Oh, let me see. How big was Uruk? It was 6 square kilometers. It was about 6 square kilometers. That is a dinosaur level meteorite. Unlucky. That's really unlucky. That's really unlucky. Goodbye, Gilgamesh. Goodbye, Gilgamesh. I don't think Gilgamesh is stopping that one. I don't think only Mesopotamia loses. What about Indus River Valley Civilization? Okay, now it's time for, what do they call it? The loser round? What about the bubonic plague versus the meteor? Who wins? Whose consequences will be felt longer? Meteor? Meteor covered in bubonic plague? I feel like that's like... I feel like, you know, actually, I was gonna say that sounds OP, but... even if the meteor was covered in the bubonic plague, the bubonic plague would burn up on entry. Okay, picture this. Hang on. What about this? Hang on. Give me a second to set the stage. I have to set this up in my head. Okay. I have to think. This is going to be a tough matchup. Alexander the Great. Okay. Alexander the Great versus the original rat that carried the Black Plague. The original rat that carried the Black Plague versus Alexander the Great. Who wins? Who wins? Alexander eats, but I feel like if he eats the rat, then the rat wins in the long term, right? But like the rat just had a strategy that it was cooking up. Why the fuck would he eat the rat? I don't know. He was like a gay person, you know? Yeah, wasn't he gay? Wasn't Alexander gay for like his best friend? Didn't he stop his conquest because his best friend died and he like wept at his statue for like a month? Hang on. Was Alexander the Great gay? Oh, it looks like he was bisexual. He also executed the doctor. Huh? I see. Either straight or eat rats. I mean, I'm gay and I would never eat a rat, okay? I would never eat a rat. Rats are rats are friends, not food. You know? Also, hang on. While this is a riveting conversation, can we give a round of applause to Whores D-Vores for being first? Congratulations, Whores D-Vores. Congrats. You were first today. Nice job. Nice job. Nice job. Congratulations. Congratulations. And also, they also redeemed a Pat redeem. So let me go ahead and break that shit out real quick. What you take me to Funky Town? Thank you for the Pat redeem. I will put this to good use. Hello, Deathatron. Hi, Deathatron. This question is for you only. Deathatron, this question is for you to answer only. Who would win in a fight? Me? Or the original rat carrying the bubonic plague. Primordial rat. You would win, but wouldn't that mean the rat would win in the end? Do people today typically get vaccinated for the bubonic plague? No? So that means I would still be vulnerable. I guess it kind of depends if I knew it was the bubonic plague, you know? If I knew that it was a rat with the bubonic plague, then I would probably be over. I mean, I know we have a cure, but... Who caught the Black Plague in like 2010? Holy shit. How fast do... I don't know. Rats are kind of fast. Have you ever seen a plague tail? That should... That, they would catch up to you like instantly. Instantly. So then eat it. I feel like that would give me the plague too. You know? A meteor filled... I feel like we're going back to the space chicken program where the rats would be cooked as the meteor falls to Earth. This again? What do you mean? It's a flea? Okay. Why is it the fleas though? Just don't have fleas. I don't know. When I was a kid, I thought that having fleas was gonna be a much bigger problem than it ended up being. You know? I thought like people would be like, oh yeah, if you have the fleas, it's awful, it's really gross. And I was like, oh my god. Like, do people regularly have the fleas out there? Okay, but who would win? Okay, but who would win? Let me think real quick. The heat death of the universe, or the primordial soup in which life first formed? Who would win? The rats are in this equation, okay? This is not, the rats aren't a factor. Entropy is already winning that fight, but the soup! The soup. That's a good soup. I've been thinking... I was talking about this on Monchi's stream yesterday. But like, what if I removed my bones and I made soup out of them, you know? You know what I mean? What if I made bones out of... Or what if I made soup out of my bones? How do you think the primordial soup would taste? I feel like it'd be very sour. You wouldn't be able to lift it. Well, I mean, I'm gonna take the bones from like, let's take them from my legs. I think it would taste like seawater. I mean, I don't know if you're wrong. I don't know if you're wrong. Oh yeah! I wanna tell you, before we get into Oblivion, I wanna tell you guys about some of the things I've gotten up to in the past few days. So, I finished a course on the fundamentals of learning Python. Which, if you don't know, is a programming language. And so I've made a few a little bit funky programs. One of the programs that I made is a program that rolls 12 million die. And it rolls 12 million dice at once. That was a fun one to make. Does it crash your PC? No, actually it doesn't. And then I wrote another program that compiles like the count of all the die that got rolled. So like it'll tell me how many ones, twos, threes, fours, fives, and sixes I got. And then I was like, wait a second, I could do, since I'm already dealing with millions here, I could go a step farther. And I made another program that buys Powerball lottery tickets until I hit the jackpot. And it, at the very end, it tells me how many tickets it took me to win. And it also tells me how much money I've spent doing it. I think that one is a very applicable program. And I lost. So here's the thing. So it takes ages to run because it's dealing with millions. So it takes like 4 or 5 minutes to run once. And the one time I had the patience to like run the whole thing, I got a Powerball win in half the amount of tries it would take like in average. But the thing is that I still... So I won. So the odds are like... The odds are like 1 in 229 million, okay? I want you to put that into perspective. The odds of winning the Powerball jackpot are like 1 in 229 million. I won after buying 112 million tickets. And I still lost overall $100 million. I lost $100 million because the cost of Powerball tickets is $2, right? And I spent so the Powerball tickets are $2 each. I bought 112 million tickets, and so I spent overall like $224 million to buy these tickets, and I won $112, or like somewhere around there. Does that include taxes? No. So I would have lost more. What did you use to make your program work? I used a while. I did while win equals false. Or I said while not win. And then I did a for loop, which is it. I made a function that basically rolls like a random number in between 1 and 229 million. And in the program, if it rolls a 1 in that program, then I've won the Powerball, is basically how I did it. I felt like that was the easiest way to do it. Started learning Python middle of last year. Right now I'm experimenting with with reading from files, because that wasn't something that was covered in the guide that I was reading. So it's kind of easy, or it's not easy. I don't know why I said easy. It's definitely not easy. It's kind of interesting to try out like reading from files, so I can like save like program data and stuff. I took a break from my recent project to watch stream. Nice. Maybe I'll do like some stream where I just make like stupid stuff in Python. You're gonna love objects? The thing I hate the most, the thing I hated learning about the most was lists where Every item in the list is a dictionary, and also dictionaries where every value is a dictionary. I really hated that. That was my least favorite thing to learn about. Lists are great. I love lists, but I hate dictionaries. I love lists, but I hate dictionaries. Lists aren't convoluted. It's dictionaries that are convoluted. I don't like dictionaries. But anyways. Okay, I've been talking for like half an hour. Let's get into the game. Let's get into the game.